Century as a journalist, and literary figures would absolutely roll their eyes if a journalist was described as a literary figure, because we are wordsmiths in instant news business. So I don't know whether literature has anything much to do with it, but thank you anyway for the lovely introduction. You know, when Firoz told me that I'm supposed to talk here for 10 minutes to a gathering of people who know so much about the world of, you know, people with disability and the challenges that they face. These are people who work day in and day out, have committed their lives to the service of people with disability. I was completely panic-stricken because till 2 years back, I had almost nothing to do with you know, this world of disability. I was a writer, and over the last few years, after I gave up my journalism career, I have spent my life tracking the lives of very successful people, if you will, but successful in a very different kind of way. So they were super successful people, but people who essentially have lived largely a life of privilege, and that privilege has kind of given them a stepping stone into the kind of success they've achieved. And then I'm a great believer in destiny. 3 years ago, when I launched my second book, Legacy, which is a book of letters from eminent parents to their daughters, I called my dear friend Firoz for the launch of that book. And after that book was launched by him, we got talking, and then we realized that we shared a lot of concerns, share similar views on a lot of subjects. And then at one point he said, why don't we write a book about people with disability? For a moment I blanked out, because you get comfortable writing about the kind of things that you're you know, used to doing. And then suddenly to be said, to be asked to do a book on disability, for me it was a moment of, you know, reckoning, if you will, because it would mean stepping out of my comfort zone and going into an area which I had very little to do with. Like most of us in this room, probably, or maybe not in this room, but most of us in life, I had not had really anything to do with, you know, I've not had any close contact with people with disability, except, you know, in college I had read for somebody who was visually impaired. You would probably help somebody to cross the road. You know, just those little human things that we do, but not really anything to do to understand their lives completely. But I think the journalist in me also had this great curiosity about things, and Firoz's passion kind of catalyzed me into action, and I said, okay, let's do it. Let's do this book on people with disability. And the first day that I went to do an interview with one of the people, one of the stars, 15 stars of our book, I went with, my knees were fairly shaking with fear, because, you know, when I walked in, I think the first person I met was Siddharth Jayakumar. Is he here today? Siddharth is very much, oh there is. My dear friend Siddharth. I was supposed to meet him in a hotel. He was coming in from Chennai to meet me, and I had come in from Bombay, and I was cribbing about my back pain because the flight had been not very comfortable. And then Siddharth called me and said, I'm in the lobby, come and meet me. So I went down the lobby, and he said, I'm coming down in the elevator. So I was kind of very nervous, because I knew that he had cerebral palsy, and I knew very little about cerebral palsy, and when I set out doing this book, I was determined that I wouldn't read a lot of research on you know, various forms of disability, because I wanted to catch their human spirit. I wanted to catch their reality as it is, and I didn't want this to be a book of great research and, you know, a textbook which nobody would want to read. So I was wondering how this first meeting would be. I was not, you know, then the elevator door opened and this brilliant sunshine came out of the lift, and he said, hi, I'm Siddharth. And then he led me to the hotel restaurant, and then he helped himself to tea and breakfast, and all the while I had this inner dialogue going on saying, you know, do I offer to pour this tea out for him? Do I pull a chair out for him? Do I ask him, is he comfortable? And at the end of it, I forgot all of those things because Siddharth's story was so fascinating that I simply forgot to ask all the questions related to his, I'm not sure whether to even call it disability because as I know it, Siddharth is not disabled. Siddharth is much more able than a lot of us. And the other day he was at my, at the Chennai launch of our book and somebody asked Siddharth, how is it to be called disabled? And he said, why do you want to call me disabled? I'm Siddharth, call me Siddharth. And that is the, you know, for me, that is the core of this book that Firoz and I have written, Gifted. And Gifted is a stories of 15 completely sterling, completely brilliant men and women who have taken on life and made this into a wonderful gift that each one of us can learn from. You know, each of them had severe disability of some form or the other. There is this wonderful young man, he is sitting here, Ashwin. There he is. Ashwin, when I met him in Bangalore, he told me, you know, we had breakfast somewhere and then he was telling me the story of his life. And he said to me that when he was born, the doctors told his mother that your baby has cerebral palsy, he's a quadriplegic, and he will never be anything more than a doll. Take him home by all means, but don't expect anything from him because he cannot do anything in life. And it is completely such a wonderful thing to know that Siddharth went on to become the country's first software engineer and is now a very, very gifted employee at Mphasis.